Australia is upgrading its tanks, buying 75 M1A2 Abrams tanks, plus some support vehicles for $2.5 billion. With cutting-edge technology, advanced protection, and seamless integration with other military assets, these tanks are more than just machines of war. They're a testament to Australia's commitment to safeguarding its future. But can they withstand drone attacks? Does Australia need tanks, and did we pay too much? Let's take a look. I'm Mel Pikos, and today, we're talking tactics. Why new tanks? The M1A2 tank is being introduced in Australia to replace the M1A1 tank. So let's take a quick look at those. In 2004, the Australian government debated the Army's need for tanks, but ultimately decided to replace the Leopard AS1 tanks, which had been delivered to Australia in batches between 1976 and 1978. They were replaced with 59 M1A1 Abrams AIM tanks, which entered service in 2007, alongside seven M88A2 Hercules armoured recovery vehicles. The M1A1 tanks are approximately 9.83 metres long by 3.65 metres wide and 2.89 metres tall. It holds a crew of four, a commander, a gunner, a loader and a driver, and can travel at more than 60 kilometres per hour on standard terrain. Its weapons include a 120mm M256 smoothbore cannon, a 12.7mm M2HB QCB machine gun, two 7.62mm MAG-58 machine guns, plus a 66mm M250 grenade launcher. The Australian M1A1 tanks have never been deployed in a combat zone. However, in October 2024, the Albanese government announced they would be providing military aid of 49 of the old M1A1 tanks to Ukraine as part of the ongoing conflict with Russia. The acquisition plan. In 2022, then Minister for Defence Peter Dutton announced a $3.5 billion investment into Australia's heavy armour capability. Land 907 will deliver 75 M1A2 Abrams SEPV-3 main battle tanks, 29 new M1150 assault breach vehicles. These are used for breaching minefields and other battlefield obstacles, plus minor earthworks, all while keeping crew safe inside the vehicle. 17 joint assault bridges, which enable gap crossings, and six M88A2 armoured recovery vehicles for repair and recovery of vehicles on the battlefield. 160 M1 Abrams vehicles, previously withdrawn from service in the US, are being purchased, and they will then be converted into the 127 total vehicles Australia is developing. At least 46 of the new M1A2 Abrams battle tanks have been received, and initial operating capacity is expected to be delivered in 2025. What is the M1A2 SEPV-3 Abrams? The M1A2 Abrams System Enhancement Package version 3 incorporates advanced features to enhance combat effectiveness, survivability, and sustainability. It is 9.8 meters long, 3.7 meters wide, 2.4 meters tall, and still crewed by four, a driver, a commander, a loader, and a gunner, and has a top speed of over 65 kilometers per hour. Its main gun is still the 120mm M256 smoothbore cannon, which can fire advanced kinetic energy and advanced multi-purpose rounds. It also comes with an ammunition data link that allows for programming new ammunition coming into service for different effects, like point detonate, delay, and airburst. It will feature a low-profile, common remotely operated weapons system from Kongsberg, installed with a 12.7mm machine gun and a 7.62mm M240 machine gun. This will enable the crew to operate a mounted weapon from inside the vehicle, keeping them protected from enemy fire. According to Warrant Officer Class 1 Bernie Mouse, the tank's most significant upgrade was a commander's independent thermal viewer, a sighting system that operates separately from the turret. If my main gun is facing 3 o'clock, I can scan in another direction and quickly bring the main gun on target without needing to direct the gunner. That's a huge upgrade to the system. It's also equipped with advanced fire control systems, including a digital ballistic computer, laser range finder, and thermal imaging sights, allowing for effective targeting and engagement of enemy. It's not known whether these tanks would include the Trophy active protection system. However, they are fitted for future installation of that system. There are several other key upgrades that enhance its operational capability. The auxiliary power unit allows the tank to operate its systems without the need to keep the main engine running. Network upgrades provide improved communications and integration with allied forces, ensuring seamless coordination on the battlefield. The tank's stronger armor offers increased protection against modern threats, while the improved forward-looking infrared equipment enhances target acquisition in low visibility conditions. Additionally, the upgraded day camera improves situational awareness, allowing the crew to detect and engage targets with greater precision, day or night. Tanks still matter in modern warfare. The acquisition of the M1A2 Set V3 Abrams represents a significant step forward in ensuring Australia's defence forces are prepared for the evolving challenges of modern warfare. But there's plenty of discussion around things like drone attacks, which some say make these types of vehicles useless in combat situations. These can be defended against with things like active protection systems, but are they enough? What do you think? Is Australia's decision to modernise its tank fleet with the M1A2 Abrams a good decision? Is this a wise investment for our defence strategy? Or should we prioritise other technologies? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. Only 8% of you watching are actually subscribed, and I would love to get that number up to 10%. That's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been talking tactics.